Well, the city that never sleeps gets a royal wake-up call tomorrow as England's Queen Elizabeth makes a long overdue visit to New York City. CNN's Richard Roth has more on Mom's travel plans this week.
It will be Queen for half day in New York City.
Her Majesty, the Queen of England, will be here, going to visit.
Her first visit since 1976.
She's not been to New York in 30 years.
Well, we're not giving it back.
She hasn't been here since...
She's been here for many years, but...
Does she not like New York?
Oh, she'll love it. She'll love it. Why not?
At Tea and Sympathy in Greenwich Village, the Queen is already here. But owner and dual citizen Nikki Perry is upset she won't be here for the Queen.
I would love to offer her a nice piece of Welsh rarebit and a proper cup of tea.
I tried to prepare the former commoners.
Can you bow for me? Not bad. What would you tell her?
What would I tell her? That you're beautiful.
Don't you tell that to all the women on the street in the summer here?
I do, but there's a different beauty involved here.
If she's around and wants to get high tea with me, just give me a call. No, she was very cordial last time we had it.
I'd try and sell her a diamond watch.
You think she needs jewelry?
Could be. Everyone needs jewelry.
What do Americans not know? I mean, we don't know what it's like to have a queen.
You've got plenty of queens in America.
A queen could have some royal fun in the big city.
She makes very highly scripted visits. She isn't going to be doing what Prince Harry did the other day in New York, getting on a polo pony and falling off, which made news all around.
Some New Yorkers would rather the grandkids stayed longer.
You would like to have tea with her?
Yeah, or her grandsons.
I now respectfully request Her Majesty.
The Queen will first speak to the world at the United Nations, as she did in 1957. The Queen was 31 years old then when she noted the UN's problems.
Time has, in fact, made the task of the United Nations more difficult than it seemed when the terms of the Charter were agreed at San Francisco 12 years ago.
Then it's a motorcade trip downtown, perhaps passing this musician.
I think she would just go, you know, like this, like she does to everyone, instead of like that, which would be pretty cool.
The Queen visits where the Twin Towers stood and a garden where the 67 British citizens who died on 9/11 are remembered.
This is the place for the British, and it's also about the unity of our two nations. You know, we've been, ever since we got over 1776, we've been shoulder to shoulder.
I'll say God bless the Queen.
What about God save the Queen?
God save the Queen, too.
Richard Roth, CNN, New York.